Back here at home, investors are bracing for the latest policy decision of the Philippine Central Bank that's expected after trading hours today. Now, yesterday, BSP Governor Felipe Medalla has hinted that the rate hike would either be 25 or 50 basis points. And he's not ruling out further tightening either to tame inflation back within the central bank's 2 to 4% target range starting next year.
I already said, not zero, not 75, right? So it's probably more than a coin toss. But I will not say which side of the coin is heavier. Okay? As to whether there will be more rate hikes, the remaining meetings, we will not rule them out because, as you know, we want the midpoint of the forecast for next year to be below 4. And the midpoint of the forecast for 2024 to be closer, as close to 3 as possible.
All right, now big companies like the San Miguel Corporation not yet feeling the pinch of the sugar supply issue. San Miguel CFO Ferdinand Constantino says a bigger problem they're facing is high import costs. They're now looking for ways to acquire cheaper but quality local materials and ingredients. Constantino admits they may have to start hiking the prices of their goods eventually.
We are not very big sugar consumers, no? We have a very small soft drinks business. And in terms of food, it's not also very large. No? Fortunately, of course, we also have a lot of importations. So what we're trying to do, aside from hedging our dollar obligations, we're doing a lot of substitution. If we can substitute local raw materials instead of importing, then we do that, especially in the food sector. Sometimes you have no choice but to pass on to consumers some of these cost increases.
The United Sugar Producers Federation questioning the claims of some businesses that there is a shortage of refined sugar. Its president Manuel Lamata insists there's still some supply left from an earlier batch of imports. He believes supply is not the issue, but overpricing.
Imagine they buy sugar from us at 45 pesos per kilo and they're selling it at 100, 110. The importation of 200,000 metric tons of refined, which came in June of this year, and it's still coming in. That I think there's another batch of 20,000 tons left to be coming in the country. 130,000 plus is still in the bodegas, not withdrawn. DTI should step up to the plate and inspect all sugar mills, all bodegas of the traders.
Former Agri-Secretary Leonardo Montemayor, meanwhile, believes the Sugar Regulatory Administration consulted with stakeholders before declaring the need to import more supply. But he's not dismissing profiteering behind the rising prices of sugar.
When you look at it on its face value, rising prices would be an indicator, but not the only indicator of a gap between the demand, in this case for sugar, and the supply, whether actual or projected. I think there is also a strong case for the point, I believe, made by Manolet Lamata here, that there is likely profiteering. Ang laki po ng agwat ng buying price for their cane and their raw sugar as against the retail price.
Now, it's not just sugar. Supply of white onions here in the Philippines is also supposedly dwindling. But the farmers group says government should delay any plans to import since there's still enough supply of red onions. Now, last week, the price of white onions soared to 400 pesos per kilo in some public markets, even those that still had them.
Hindi naman din kami against sa importation kung talagang kailangan. Ang pakiusap namin na sana ay maunti lang talaga kung talagang kailangan.
Fast food chain Burger King is among the businesses affected by the shortage of white onions in the country. The Makati Business Club weighs in on the dwindling supply and rising prices of some basic goods in the country. Speaking to us this morning, MBC Executive Director Coco Alcuaz says during their meeting with Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, they presented an argument to let market forces just work. He says allowing manufacturers to raise prices in the meantime as the country deals with elevated inflation is better alternative than letting them go out of business.
Very strong interest in manufacturing. Ooh. Also, of course, inflation. And we press the point that it's very important that market forces be allowed to work. In the past 2 years during the pandemic, some suggested retail prices weren't allowed to go up, and that was to keep prices down. But that really hurts the manufacturers. If the manufacturers can't raise prices, then they can't buy raw materials and they can't produce, then you'll have a real shortage. So you have to let markets adjust and work. And if the prices need to go up a bit, then you have to do it. Otherwise, you get a real shortage because the manufacturers can't supply.